William Morrow and Harper Audio present Hate Follow, a novel by Erin Quinn-Kong, performed by Carolyn Jania. For my parents, who believed I could write a book long before I did, and for my children, who inspired me to put words on the page. Chapter 1. Whitney. Everything looked perfect. Surveying her home's expansive living area, Whitney Golden was proud of the lavish winter wonderland she'd created. There were not one, not two, but three Christmas trees. One decorated in dazzling shades of gold, another all white, from the lights to the star on top, and the third, set up on the back patio overlooking the pool, with old-fashioned glass ornaments that reminded her of a Norman Rockwell painting. Personalized plaid stockings adorned the mantel above the blazing fireplace. Poinsettia-dotted garland and white twinkle lights lined the staircase banister, and the dining table was set for a festive dinner party. This was the Christmas scene Whitney had dreamed of as a little girl, and it was exactly right for the variety of holiday photos she had planned for that afternoon. The thought of shooting all the photos she needed to create content for the rest of the year made her giddy. As "All I Want for Christmas Is You" blared from the speakers, squeals of delight came from her 10-year-old twin daughters, Chloe and Charlotte, and 3-year-old son, Mason, who were in the kitchen with their Aunt Rosie, Whitney's youngest sister, who was living with them while attending college in town. Judging by the scent of chocolate in the air, Rosie had made cookies. Whitney hoped the kids didn't stain the outfits she'd picked out for them. She looked at her watch. Where was Mia? School had been out for an hour, and it took only 20 minutes to walk home from the high school. They couldn't start the family photos until she arrived. Whitney's Instagram followers, all 1 million of them, loved family shots.
"Whitney, we're ready for you,"
the photographer called from the back porch where he'd set up the first scene. Sweat shimmered on his forehead. They might have been creating winter content, but the October sun was beating down, and it was a steamy 80 degrees in Austin, Texas.
"I'll be right there."
Whitney grabbed her phone off the coffee table. No texts or missed calls from Mia. Whitney had planned the shoot meticulously to include her oldest, and she hated making everyone wait. At least her boyfriend of 6 months, Ace, was right where he should be, standing across the room at the bar, where she'd placed a trio of holiday nutcrackers surrounded by tinsel. He was sipping his signature cocktail, a bourbon on the rocks. She'd kill for a drink right now. A heavy pour of red wine and probably one of those cookies would be her reward after the shoot was over. A smile lit up her face when they made eye contact. Ace's presence was part of the reason she wanted this shoot to go perfectly. After months of teasing her followers with strategic shots of a tall, dirty blonde mystery man, a glimpse of his chiseled jawline here, a photo of them hugging from behind there, she was ready to hard launch him as her boyfriend on all her social channels. The plan was to get a few shots of just the two of them against a neutral background, so she could post the reveal whenever they were ready, preferably before the holiday rush started. The air in the room shifted as the front door creaked open.
"Mia?"
she called. A sigh confirmed it was, in fact, her daughter. Whitney headed toward the foyer, excited to see what her firstborn thought of the holiday decor. But when she came around the corner, her 15-year-old looked anything but enthused.
"What are you wearing?"
Mia's eyes were wide. "I can ask you the same thing," Whitney thought, taking in her daughter's baggy t-shirt, denim cutoffs, and hoodie tied around her waist. But she had to admit Mia possessed the fresh-faced glow she could never recapture as a 37-year-old mom of four, no matter how many serums she slathered on her face. Whitney looked down at her hunter green lace midi dress with elbow-length lace sleeves, paired with crimson pointed heels and perfectly matched lipstick. One of several outfits she had planned for today's shoot. Her assistant, Gabby, was currently steaming each piece of clothing in the breakfast nook so everything was crisp and ready for her to pull on. She put her hands on her hips and preened.
You don't like it?
A bit much for a random Thursday in October, isn't it? A frown touched Mia's lips. Smiling, Whitney flicked her long, wavy auburn hair, which was mostly extensions, off her shoulders.
No, silly. Today's the Christmas shoot, remember?
Her daughter scowled in response. Uh-oh, Mia wasn't happy. That seemed to be the case more and more. While Whitney would have once called her daughter an old soul, Mia had really been leaning into the teenage thing lately.
Come on, it'll be fun.
She put her arm around her daughter's shoulders.
What do you think of the decorations?
Instead of replying, Mia shook off her arm and stepped away. Whitney's stomach dropped. She could practically see the storm cloud hovering over Mia's head. Her eldest daughter was not going to make things easy, and Whitney needed her to make this easy, because they had a lot of photos to shoot in a short amount of time. Before Whitney could say anything else, Tawny, her friend of nearly 20 years and trusty hair and makeup artist, came around the corner. Clad in her signature business on the top, party on the bottom look, black button-down shirt, flawless makeup, and her hair in short black finger waves, paired with ripped jeans and tie-dye printed Crocs. She did a little jig when she saw Mia.
How you doing, girly?
Tawny pulled the teen in for a quick hug. Mia's face lit up in her first smile in weeks before falling.
Tired.
Her turquoise eyes were dark and sad, and the exhaustion on her face was evident. A part of Whitney's heart squeezed. She knew Mia had been up late studying for her biology test.
How did the test go?
Whitney asked. Did your extra cramming session help? But before Mia could reply, the photographer invaded their group.
Can we get started?
He sounded irritated.
1 minute.
She turned to her daughter. Your dress is upstairs. It's gorgeous. Your favorite color. We only need a few family shots, okay? Mia looked at her with contempt, something she'd perfected recently.
No, I'm going to take a nap.
Whitney forced a smile, hoping Mia wouldn't cause a scene.
Oh, don't be a grouch. It'll only take a few minutes.
Resolute anger flared on Mia's face.
You and I both know it'll take hours to get the perfect shot.
She used her fingers to make air quotes.
Not today.
Listen, Whitney hissed. She hated being unprofessional, and Mia was backing her into a corner.
I'm not making a request. Go up and get dressed, and then come down for hair and makeup.
Her daughter's eyes flashed.
Seriously? I'm not your employee.
Whitney threw her hands into the air.
Why are you being like this?
She hated the whiny tinge in her own voice.
You used to love these shoots.
She thought back to the last family shoot they'd had on Labor Day weekend. Mia had started out looking sullen and refused to wear makeup, but after a bit, she'd been laughing and posing for the camera with her siblings. Whitney chalked up her daughter's recent moodiness to starting high school. She'd always struggled with change. Mia scoffed.
Yeah, Mom, you know me so well.
Whitney saw the fury on her daughter's face. Tawny must have seen it too, because she stepped between them.
Okay, let's all relax a bit.
The commotion had caught the attention of everyone in the large room, including the photographer. He shook his head at his assistant, who looked almost as young as Mia. Ace headed their way, a typical carefree grin on his face.
Everything all right over here?
Mia doesn't want to do the shoot. She massaged her temples, where a dull ache had started.
Come on, Mia.
Ace said.
Your red hair will look awesome in these shots.
Mia's long, thick, copper-colored hair was so stunning that strangers on the street stopped her to comment on it, much to her dismay. Mia didn't bother to conceal her eye roll. Crossing her arms, Whitney glared at her daughter.
No need to be rude.
She paused, deciding what move to make.
If you don't do this, you're grounded for 3 weeks.
Mia's laugh was hollow.
We both know you're not home enough to actually enforce that.
Before Whitney could reply, Mia turned and sprinted up the stairs, pounding down the hallway before slamming her bedroom door. Whitney rubbed her forehead and tears filled her eyes. She was tired too, and now she had a throbbing headache. Ace snaked his arm around her waist.
Don't worry, babe. We'll get some nice photos without her.
She groaned. Trust me, it's not that simple. Everyone will ask in the comments, where's Mia? Where's Mia? And then they'll start making up theories about why she's not in the holiday photos. Or they'll say I'm a bad mom for not including her.
It's not the end of the world.
Tawny gently took her by the arm and steered her into the makeshift makeup chair they'd fashioned in one corner of the living room.
Let's give your face a touch-up and brainstorm reasons to tell your followers why Mia isn't in the photos. While you do that, I'm going to check out those cookies.
Ace arched his eyebrows at them.
Can I bring you ladies anything?
Maybe later, thanks. Whitney smiled as she watched him saunter to the kitchen. Dabbing a tissue under her eyes, she looked at Tawny in the mirror.
So much for the fun shoot I thought we were going to have.
She sniffed.
I don't get her anymore.
Tawny tilted her head.
She's 15. Don't you remember how hard that age is?
Whitney thought back to her own freshman year in high school in the Texas Panhandle. She never saw her parents, who both worked 16 hours a day yet barely made ends meet. After she finished classes every day, she walked to the elementary school to pick up her 4 younger siblings, and then made sure they were fed. Some days all they had were bologna sandwiches and canned corn, bathed and finished their homework before bed. She'd been a good student, like Mia, but she'd never gotten a chance to shine because she was too busy raising her siblings. Being in a photo shoot sounded like heaven compared to that. She shuddered, pushing the memories away. Posing for a few photos is not a big deal. Tawny quickly freshened up Whitney's lipstick.
I remember high school like it was yesterday. It's a complicated time for everyone, especially when your mother is a gorgeous influencer.
Whitney's cheeks heated. Tawny was merely trying to butter her up, but she appreciated the compliment. Tawny placed her warm hands on her shoulders.
Give her a break. She's had a hard life, too.
Tears pricked Whitney's eyes yet again. Her gaze wandered to the mantle, where there was a photo of her, Mia, and the twins with her husband, Michael. She knew her eldest daughter was still grappling with her father passing away unexpectedly nearly 4 years before. Sometimes that felt like a lifetime ago. Wait, what was today's date?
Oh my God! Whitney covered her mouth with her hand. The anniversary of Michael's death was on Tuesday. There's been so much going on with work, I completely forgot. I'm such a jerk.
She started to get up from the chair.
I have to talk to Mia.
Just then, the photographer appeared next to Tawny in the mirror, and he looked downright pissed.
We've got to get moving.
He tapped his watch.
I was booked for 3 hours, and almost an hour is gone.
Looking toward the stairs, Whitney felt her heart tug. She really needed to speak with Mia, to tell her she was sorry for forgetting the day that changed their lives forever. But it was clear from the look on the photographer's face that he wasn't going to wait a moment longer. She blew out a deep breath. She should let Mia nap,
After the shoot, she'd have a good, long talk with her daughter.
I'm ready,
Whitney said, squaring her shoulders.
We're doing the shoot with only the little kids today.
Got it. Let's go.
The photographer hustled back to his camera, which was ready and waiting on a tripod.
Hey, kiddos.
She put on her sunshine mom voice as she called out to Chloe, Charlotte, and Mason, who were playing in the living room with Ace and Rosie.
Who wants presents?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.